नमस्ते सुप्रभातम चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास। टेक आउट योर टेक्स्ट बुक एंड ओपन पेज नंबर 86। लेट अस स्टार्ट द क्लास विद अ पोम। ओके, द पोम नेम इज लिटिल बर्ड्स सॉन्ग, रिटन बाय मार्गरेट रोज। शी इज द ऑथर ऑफ दिस पोम। ऑथर मीन्स द पोएट, द वन हु has written this poem. This is a poem all about a brown little bird which used to sit on a tree always and sing a song and entertain everybody in the garden. Okay, children, you can also write a story or a poem of your own. Instead of always watching TV or playing with your mobile, you can also write a poem or a story of your own, so that it will help you to think creatively. Okay, you can write it in your diary or a notebook or a paper, and you at the end of the story or a poem, you can also write your name. Like, see how Margaret Rose has written this poem and she has written her name at the end of the poem. Like this, even you can do. Okay. Now, let's get back to the poem. We'll learn this poem. It's a beautiful poem and easy one. We will learn it. Okay. Sometimes I have seen, sometimes I have heard, up in a tree, a little bird. Singing a song to me, a little brown bird up in the tree. Sometimes he stays, sometimes he sings, then to the wind he spreads his wings. Flying away, away from me, a little brown bird up in the tree. Once again. Sometimes I have seen, sometimes I have heard, up in the tree, a little bird, singing a song to me, a little brown bird, up in the tree. Sometimes he stays, sometimes he sings, then to the wind he spreads his wings, flying away. Away from me, a little brown bird up in the tree. After the poem, open lesson number 9, Dear Animal. Will Dear Animal Day. This lesson is all about a fancy dress competition which was held in the school. Each children will dress up about in their favorite animal and they will participate in the fancy dress competition. You also know, children, when you were in UKG, you had many fancy dress competition, Veshabhushana Sparde. In that you dressed yourself as Kitturani Chennamma and other personalities also, right? And some of you got a prize, correct? So, like this also, in this lesson, some small children like you had a fancy dress competition in their school. It was about animal. They had to get dressed up as animal. So, some children dressed up in their favorite animal and participated in the fancy dress competition. Let us see later. Before that, we will do this page, get set page. Which of these do you do in school? Put a tick or a cross in each box. Whatever you do in school, you have to put a tick mark. Whatever you do not do in school, you have to put a X mark. Okay, first picture they have done. It is about sharing lunch with your friends. Do you share lunch with your friends in school? Yes. Put a tick mark. Do you take your grandparents to school and talk with them? No. So put a cross mark. School fancy dress day. You participate in school fancy dress? Yes. Put a tick mark.
Then, next picture, washing clothes. Do you wash clothes in school? No. Put a cross mark. Do you play games with your friends? Yes. Put a tick mark. Do you do drawing in your school? Yes. Put a tick mark. Okay. And have pencil with you. I will tell all the difficult words. You have to underline. Okay. Today, mommy did not have to wake up Ben. He got up on his own. He got up early too. He woke up his parents. Ben was very happy. It was a fancy dress day in school. Underline, mummy, 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 wake, wake. This boy name is Ben. He had a fancy dress competition in the school. So he was very happy. Okay, that day his mother didn't wake him up. He only got up early and he woke his parents up because he was so happy that he was thinking that he will be enjoying in the school. He was so happy. So he woke up early and he woke up his parents also. Then underline fancy, 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 dress, dress. Okay. Parents, parents, parents. Okay. So he was so happy that there was a fancy dress in the school. Miss Iyer was Ben's teacher. As I am your class teacher or your English teacher, Miss Iyer, her name was Iyer. She was Ben's teacher. She had asked the children to dress up as animals. The show was named Dear Animal Day. So what happened? That day was Ben's fancy dress competition in the school. Miss Iyer was Ben's teacher. She told all the children to dress up as animals. Okay. And the fancy dress theme was Dear Animal Day. So all the children had to dress up in animal, in some animal as animal and come to school. Ben brushed his teeth, underline brushed, B-R-U-S-H-E-D, brushed his teeth. He had a bath. Papa took out Ben's brown pajamas and jacket, underline jacket, J-A-C-K-E-T, jacket. Ben wanted to dress up as a lion. He loved lions. So what did Ben do? He brushed his teeth, he took bath. And what did Papa do? He took out brown pajama and jacket. See, he is wearing brown pajama and jacket in the picture. Okay. He wanted to dress up as a lion. Ben's favorite animal was lion. So he wanted to dress himself as lion. That's why his papa got him brown jacket and brown pajamas. Okay, so he brushed his teeth first, happily he took a bath and he got ready with brown pajama and jacket. Mummy cut chart paper into round shape, underline chart, C-H-A-R-T, chart, and round, R-O-U-N-D, round. Mummy cut chart paper into a round shape. She cut out a circle in the middle. She pasted brown wool over it. The lion had a thick mane now. Then she painted whiskers on Ben's face. Ben was a lion. What happened, mummy? See how nicely she has done. She had taken a big chart paper and a brown paper and she cut it into round to match the lion's face. Then what happened? She cut out a circle in the middle also. See, she has done a circle in the middle also, and she pasted a brown wool all over it. The face of a lion. Imagine the face of a lion. It will have brown hairs, right? So to match that hair, she took out a brown wool and pasted here. Then it had a thick mane. M-A-N-E, mane. Underline mane, children. M-A-N-E, mane. Mane means a long hair, thick hair. How does a lion have? It has a thick hair around his face, right? Like mane means hair, long hair. Okay, even here, after pasting all the wool on the circle, see how nicely it is looking like a lion face. Okay. Then she painted whiskers. Underline whiskers. W-H-I-S-K-E-R-S. Whiskers on Ben's face. Then what did she do now? She painted whiskers. Whiskers means mustache. Okay, she painted whiskers, a small hair, what you see on cat, lion face. Okay, small, thin, light hair it will be. Okay, she draw that on Ben's face. See, he's looking like a lion. Ben was a lion, so he looked like a lion. Roar. Roar means making a sound of a lion. How does a lion sound, children? Oh, good. Next sentence. Ben took out his books from his school bag. It was a no books day today. Papa packed Ben's lunchbox. Mummy filled up his water bottle. What did Ben do after getting ready? He had to pack his lunch also. No, that day teacher had asked him not to bring any books. So whatever the book was there in his bag, he took them out. His father packed a light lunch for him and mummy filled up his water bottle. Underline bottle. B-O-T-T-L-E. Bottle. L-U-N-C-H. Lunch. So what did Ben's father do? He packed a lunch box and mummy filled up his water bottle. What did Ben do? He took out all the books from his school bag. Why? Because it was a no books day. Teacher had asked him not to bring any books. Even for you also, no children. When there is a fancy dress, you will not take any book except diary. You will take only lunch and water bottle. Right? So like that only in Ben's school, teacher had asked him not to bring any book to the school. It was no book day. So what did he take? Only lunch and a water bottle, and he got up, dressed himself as which animal? Lion. Ben ran out happily. Honk honk. There was a Ben's bus. What came? Ben got out happily. Underline happily. H-A-P-P-I-L-Y. He was very happy. He got ready. And fast, very fast and happy. Even you also know, when there is no books, no reading, no writing in the class, you will get up early and get ready very happily. That day you feel very happy to come to school, right? Even Ben also, he felt very happy because he didn't have to read anything that day. It was fully, whole day was a fancy dress competition. So he ran out happily and honk honk. Honk honk is a horn of a vehicle. Honk honk. There was a Ben's bus. And when he came out, the school bus had come. Kirti wanted to dress up as rabbit. Underline R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. She loved rabbits. They are soft and cute, she told her friends. She is Kirti. What did she do? She dressed up as rabbit. Kirti loved rabbit. Why she loved it? Because it was very soft. It is very soft and cute. Have you seen rabbits, children? It will be very cute and small with pink lips, right? So she liked rabbit. It will be very cute. So she, that's why she liked rabbit, and she dressed up as a rabbit. Papa got white t-shirt and white leggings for her. She cut out two long ears from chart paper. Granny painted pink marks on them. See how nicely she had dressed up. Her father had brought her white t-shirt and white leggings. And what did her grandparents do? They had made a long ears. Have you seen rabbit? It will have a long ears, right? So her grandparents made a long ears from a chart paper and painted a pink mark inside them. Okay, pink marks inside them. And she dressed up as a rabbit. See, nicely she is dressed. Kitty was a little bunny. Hop, hop, hoppity hop. She hopped all around the house. What a lovely rabbit she was. After dressing up, Kirti was very happy. So, like a rabbit, what did she do? She hopped, 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 hopped all around the house. And she was looking lovely. Underline lovely. Lovely means beautiful, cute. L-O-V-E-L-Y. Lovely. Fatima wanted to dress up as zebra. Underline zebra. Z-E-B-R-A. Zebra. She helped Amma paint black zebra stripes on old newspaper. Have you observed, children, how creative they are? One did the face of a lion with a chart paper, and Kriti's grandparents did a ear with a chart paper, and they had just owned. And her Kirti's father had just brought her white t-shirt and white leggings. Okay. And Fatima, see here, Fatima wanted to dress up as zebra. What did she do? She took out an old newspaper and she helped her mother to paint black stripes. See, on the old newspaper she took out and she drew a black stripes. Amma made a long dress from it. Fatima painted a white paper back of for the face. Abba made holes for her eyes, nose and mouth. Amma helped Fatima dress up. So what did all of them together, what did they do in Fatima's house? They took out an old newspaper. Fatima, what did she do? She took out a white paper bag for the face, and she other things she painted with black stripes. Okay, and the face. And Abba, Abba means father. In some religion, Abba they will call for father. Okay, what did her Fatima's father do for the face? She had to made a paper face, back face, right? In that he made holes for her eyes, nose and mouth. And Amma helped her to dress up as a zebra. See here how nicely they have done. Fatima, Ben and Kirti reached school. They held hands and ran into their classroom. Their friends had dressed up as peacocks, elephants and cows. Some had dressed up as tigers, giraffes, horses, monkeys and parakeets. Parakeets is parrot. They were happy to see each other. What did Fatima, Ben and Kirti all reach the school? They held each other hand and ran to their class. When they saw their friends in the class, there were so many children dressed up as peacocks, elephants, cows, tigers, giraffe, horses, monkeys, and parakeets. They were all so happy to see each other. You could hear roars, moos, and knives. They danced, hopped, underline danced, danced, danced. Nice, neigs, nice. Roars, roars, moos, moos, moos. Danced, hopped, jumped, and ran around. So, roars, moos, and neighs are the sounds of the animals. Okay, roar, tiger roars, lion roars, right? Moos, cows, moos, moos. Nice, nice is horses, horses, nice. Okay, and parakeet will speak as you speak, and giraffe, they all made you can when you enter the classroom. They saw many people acting like elephant, cow, making their noises. Correct? You know how peacocks make noise? Elephants, cows, horses, monkeys. They were all acting like this because they had all dressed up. They were dancing, they were hopping, they were jumping, and they did the fancy dress competition happily. Miss Iyer said, "I am so proud of my class." She gave storybooks to all those who took part. Everyone was happy. See here, some has dressed parrot, rabbit, monkey, parrot, elephant. See how nicely in the class also they jumped, they danced, they ran around. This is how they took part in the fancy dress competition happily. They made all the sounds of animals. So Miss Iyer, she is Miss Iyer. Okay, her name is Miss Iyer. She is a teacher. She felt very happy, and as a prize, she gave a storybook to everyone who took part in the fancy dress competition. And all the children was very happy. They enjoyed their school and that day, and they enjoyed their class that day, and they took home the storybooks as a prize, and they were very happy. Even you know, children, whenever teacher appreciates you and say good, and she gives you something as a gift or a prize, you will be very happy, no? Same way, children here also got prize and they were so happy. They all enjoyed the class that day. Hope you understood this lesson, children. Dhanyavad.